We're really excited that we've released Android L, and now we're also super excited to announce that we are releasing Google Play Services 6.5, enabling you to build better apps! Yeah! That's what this is all about. When you start using all the APIs of Google Play Services, you will be building better apps. And as always, when you develop using Google Play Services, it will run on all devices, starting with Gingerbread. So let's check out the new features in 6.5, and let's have some fun while we're doing it. High five, Gingerbread Man! So starting off with the Google Drive Android API. Imagine that your app needs to upload lots of Drive data. Let's say gigabytes. Well, in that case, you may want to ensure that you're connected to a power source and you're on a Wi-Fi network. Well, now you can programmatically specify these types of conditions for uploads. And in this release, it is also possible to cancel pending uploads that you don't want. So these features allow you to control and conserve precious resources, such as network and battery, for users of your app. Another new feature is that you can now create empty files. Nope, there's no data in here. And perhaps saving the best for last, we've now added the possibility to add public and private properties to a file. This is like custom metadata your app assigns to a file that can describe the file content. And of course, you can also use this information when doing queries. Moving over to Google Maps, which is truly an amazing product. You can navigate through the entire world using it. But sometimes you don't want to navigate through the entire world. Have you ever wanted just a small, simple map? That's exactly what Light Mode Maps provides. Here is one showing the Google Plex. Light Mode Maps allow you to serve a static image as a map, but it still supports many of the features of ordinary maps, including different map types, such as terrain and satellite. Markers and polylines are also supported. Here, you can see a mark for Google Plex, for example. And user location can also be displayed. Here, for example, is where I am right now. And since Light Mode Maps are based on a static image, there is no need for continuous server communication to update the map, so you can truly say that they are Light Mode. So if you have a bounded area or maps that are too small to interact with, or if you want to stack a number of small maps together, then you should consider using Light Mode Maps. And guess what? It is really easy to switch to full-blown map functionality. The user just needs to tap on the static image. Now we've also added a new toolbar. This toolbar works for both regular as well as Light Mode maps and enables the user to quickly open Google Maps and immediately get directions. And that brings us over to Google Wallet. Previously, we've had the Buy with Google and the various Save to Google buttons, and now we're also adding a Donate with Google button. That's right, this makes donating as easy as buying things, exactly the way that it should be. Which brings us over to a much discussed topic. Let's go really, really deep technically. Let's talk about the Google Play Services SDK and something that will help manage the 16-bit method limit of DEX files. Previous versions of the Google Play Services SDK required you to depend on all of Google Play Services through one AAR file. So your Gradle build file looked something like this. Yeah, a single line that included everything in Google Play Services. And as we've continued to add more APIs, it has proven hard to maintain a lean app. Therefore, we have unbundled this AAR file so you can select only the APIs you want to use. Here is an example Gradle build file that only uses the Maps and Ads API of Google Play Services. And while there are many aspects and ways to manage the 16-bit method limit of DEX files, this should make it easier to keep your app lean, since you select the APIs you want to include in your build. And that's almost it for this time. I say almost, because there's one more thing to cover. Let's go out in the wild and talk about the Google Fit API. Google Fit was officially released in October, so now it's high time for you to develop your applications and publish them to the Google Play Store. Here is an application, for example. Nathan has a band around his chest which allows a Google Fit application to measure and record his heartbeats while he is doing chin-ups.
Now it's your turn.
Hot dog, do I get to try? That's it for this time, but be sure to check out these resources as well. Now it's your turn to go out there and build better apps using all of these APIs. And don't forget to tell us all about it.